Jesus. I love you, Jesus Christ. With every nerve my heart touches, she cries, Jesus, Jesus. Arise. Come to our kingdom. Separate yourselves from your father and your mother. I swear, Jesus, like, there's not a man on earth that could touch a woman's heart like you do. Like your mother, Teresa. And those fabulous women, those famous women who save people and help out the Christian communities and the churches, Lord. Like, I'm just listening to your fallback. It's not that I don't believe in the Lord, but it's like, I believe in Jesus, you know? And the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. And I know my spirits are just from you, God. Because I'm real. I didn't choose those for myself, God. I know he's my daddy, but it's like, why can't I just love? I can't love a mortal man. You won't allow it, God. I try to love a spiritual man. Someone that's here with me all the time. And that was still impossible. What do you want me to do, Jesus? Don't want to just stay with family. I don't know what to do. Because I love so passionately. But you are the passion, Jesus. You are. And I think to myself, I think these things. I'm like, my best friend is schizophrenic, okay? My best friend. And a lot of you who don't get therapy, like, don't understand that. But I hope that reality really sets in for some of you. It's not pretty. It's not the way that things are supposed to be. But it's like to my heart. You know, my heart right here. I just am quenching for love, Jesus, because I don't want to be in the dark. I don't want to be in the dark. And my mom has brought me this far. My mom. I'm going to do the same for her. But only if she was locked in. I don't know how I would get her out. So it's like, I gotta trust the state and the police and just really keep us safe. Jesus, please put me to bed. I'm tired. It's been hours and I know that you want me to sleep, but I'd rather we do this.